What's up, y'all? Welcome back to another episode of Next Gen Podcast. It's your boy, Destiny, aka Grateful Kid. Happy Monday, y'all. So without further ado, man, let's get started. So why I got started? So the origins of my podcast is actually back in this spring that just passed. January. My bad. And you know, I was talking to my boy T, aka the Lemonade Man, and you know, you were both like, man, let's do a podcast, because like, your original was supposed to be me and him and you know someone else, but we were like, okay, you know, let's go to the lab, but let's do one shoot, and you know, we shot the episode and all that. And you know, it was pretty cool. And you know, so like, you know, the fact that they were pretty much on where I was on, you know what I'm saying, going to do a podcast. So we were like, man, let's do this shit again. And you know, but due to what's it called class schedule, we weren't really able to like go any really further. So we just like decided to just, you know, put it on hold. And you know, or just go on our day with our classes or anything else that we got on. So then, you know, I'm like, then you know what? When the springs when fall comes around, I'm gonna try definitely wanna do a podcast. So I'm like, okay. So fall comes around, you know, I'm doing my classes and all that. But now, okay, let me see how I want to do my podcast. So I talked to my boy T, and I'm like, bro, I want to do a podcast. He's like, okay, that's a bit. What do you want your podcast to look like? What do you want it to be about? Like, who's your target audience? This and that. And I'm like, oh, dang, I ain't never thought about that. Because I already knew that I wanted to do a podcast, but you know, no, I didn't really know what I wanted the audience to really get or what the main goal was. So I went to Carvana, my bad. It's a platform where you know you can create your logos, platforms, and all those type of things. And I just typed in podcast, and there were different templates of it. So I'm like, okay, that's what's up. And you know, I was looking around, and there were different sites. They're all good. But I'm like, okay, I saw a particular font or took a particular pamphlet where it was took out, and it was a like a speaker, like those speakers that musical artists use to record their songs. So I'm like, oh yeah, I'm taking that. You know what I'm saying? And then you know, I'm like, it would look really cool with the smoke, like a little heat on it, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes, hey, my pockets might get a little hot, you know what I'm saying? And I'm like, okay, I don't know how to do that, but again, shout out to my boy T, he actually helped me out with that, and you know, we started to adjust it, make sure like it fits right and all that, you know what I'm saying? Once we got that done, we're like, okay, I'm like, okay, how do I want it to look like? Well, I want it to look like, you know, I want it to look live. So I tap in the word live, and you know, I say it got there, and I put it on, and you know, I adjusted the course and all that, and then you know, I was like, let me look how the next gen. I know it's next gen. I wanted it to be called next gen. But how do I want the next gen to look like? So I saw a pamphlet that had electric words in it. So I'm like, okay, let me copy that real quick, and then you know, edit some things out and type in my logo, my thing, Next Gen Podcast. But I typed in the two times, and you know, it looked hard. I'm like, hey, yo, this nice. And then you know, of course, I wanted to be called Next Gen Podcast, but how do I want the podcast word to look like? So I'm like, okay, I want it to be cursive, and then I did the same thing with that, and I tapped in two times, and then you know, so I'm like, hey, my boy T, what are you thinking about this? He's like, that's pretty cool. But do you want to add a little song underneath? I'm like, no, what you mean? Like, you know, something that will grab their attention, or like something that, like, you know, that sticks out a little bit. So I'm like, nah, you got anything? He like, shit, let me try real quick. And then, you know, he typed in, he told me to type in, anything can be followed again except of time wasted. I'm like, hey, anything can be followed again except of time wasted. And I was like, okay, shit, that hard. That's good. That go hard. He's like, yeah, yeah, that go hard. And then, you know, me being host, I sound like called it hosted by Destiny, which is my middle name, Destiny. Because, you know, why not? It's Destiny. You know? And then, you know, once we were done with that, I downloaded the page, or, you know, the logo of it. And, you know, I started to talk, ask different people, like, hey, what do you think about this this logo, this you know, this font, you know, what's your opinion about it? And you know, for the majority of the audience, they were like, okay, it looks nice, like, I'll fuck with it, you know, that's what they say, you know. And I was like, okay, that's a bad. I was like, hey, do you think I should change anything, this and that? And they were like, nah, this goes hard, this and that, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I'm like, okay, bad, so I'm keeping it. You know. And once I finally decided to, okay, you know what, this is good, everybody likes it, and, you know, everybody's messing with it, so I finally decided to keep it. Now it was like, okay, where do I record? And then I realized there's a library, there's a recording room. So I'm like, okay, bad. I scanned the QR code on it, and I saw, okay, this is like the time and day, so where, like, this slot that's available. And once I got that done, I'm like, okay, you know, can I know how to do that now? It's time to get some people, you know, because I can't have no pocket about no people. And I decided to ask, in a certain group of people, like, hey, would you like to be on the podcast? They're like, well, okay, what type of podcast? And I'm like, my podcast. You know, I'm like, they're like, what's your podcast about? And I'm like, my podcast is about the next generation, next gen podcast. And you know, they'll say yes, or they'll say no. And, you know, if they say yes, you know, I'll be like, okay, cool, what day works for you, what time works for you, and, you know, we'll figure out a plan where they could show up, and, you know, we'll go from there. And you know, while they're doing that, I'll basically copy and paste and do it with each different person, and, you know, do the same thing with each person, and we'll just go from there. And they'll come in whenever they come in. I'll just, you know, go in, and, you know, we record. And my first time, I noticed that I was a little bit nervous, you know what I'm saying? And I noticed that I was like, I wasn't talking loud enough, and that was something that I needed to fix over time. And once I got confidence, I decided to, you know, okay, let's go. And then ever since then, it's been nothing but green lights, GLG, you know what I'm saying? Green light. And but then over time, I'm like, okay, you know, I'm doing all these, you know, episodes, or, you know, this podcast with different people, but what do I want the audience, or, you know, what did I want them to get from them? Or, like, what do I want the main focus to be? So I'm like, okay, what do I want the main focus to be? Okay, I want the main focus to be your experience, your opinion about certain things, regardless of what it may be. I want you to explain why you agree or disagree about a certain thing. and I want it to be a safe place, like a free judgmental place where, you know, nobody judge about their opinion, because at the end of the day, it's their opinion. You know, I'm going to have my opinion about certain things, you're going to give your opinion about certain things, and, you know, and so on. So I got that done, and then I'm like, okay, who do I really want to be on my podcast? I'm like, shit, anybody, really. Anybody that's willing to be on the podcast that will talk about a particular thing or a particular matter that's going on around the world or whatnot, if they're willing, they could come on the podcast. And, you know, and so I got that done. Then I'm like, okay, what is the main objective? Well, the main objective is to, what's it called? The main objective is to, for them to give, like I said, give their opinion about a certain thing, and for the other audiences like yourself who's listening to this podcast to be open-minded, or like, oh wow, I never thought about it like that before, for a particular matter, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, I also wanted to be part of for those who were, you know, Christian who and have belief in God, or, you know, and all that, like myself, I wanted to be a career platform for that too, where, you know, we could talk our work with God, and, you know, give our own how we met God, or, you know, how God has impacted our life, how he's changed our life, like he has done for me, you know. And that was, like, you know, my three main goals, you know. And yeah, that's pretty much why I really started it. It was just to create a safe environment for everybody, whether you believe in God or you don't believe in God, just to talk about your own perspective about certain things and give your own take on it, and feel welcome as well, you know what I'm saying? Like myself, I am in no position to judge anybody, because I am, you know, again, I am just a humble servant that is trying and willing to do the works of God, because I've gone through so many things in my life to a point where I cannot say that, you know, God does not exist, because I know God exists, because he's done so many things for me, and, you know, continues to do so amazing things for me as well. For example, today I got to wake up. I didn't wake up because, oh, you know, for my power, it's by Jesus Christ's power, you know? So I always have to give him thanks for everything that I do and will do with my life, because without him, again, I will not be here today. But besides that, I also wanted to hear other people's opinion about certain things, or like their view on music, like how music has impacted their lives, or, you know, if you're a musician, how did you fall in love with music? And, like, was this a family thing? Was this something that you picked up over time? Was this something that you just decided to do one day? Like, you know, how did you fall in love with that, with the idea of music? Or, like, how did you find music? You know, that's like an example. And, you know, and I wanted to, want the guests to, you know, come in and talk about that particular thing. And, you know, and I'll just be, you know, be open-minded. You know, because I'm an open-minded person, so of course I want to give their intakes about certain things, and, you know, what they say could even help me out with a particular issue or a particular problem, or, you know, whatever that case may be, it could be beneficial. So that's another factor why I created it, because, you know, I want to soak in any information or any knowledge that would anybody else want to give to me, so I could give it to y'all, you know. And, you know, it's been nothing but a blessing to do this podcast with many amazing people like Amari Cooper, Jade, E. She knows who she is. She's my favorite person. T. Dasha Fonto. So many other people too. And, you know, they've helped me just overall develop my skills as a podcaster, as a person as well, and also just help me just overall do better and be better. You know what I'm saying? And also too, I wanted to be part of a group of young people that are doing something while they in college. You know, I want, because you know, I wanted to feel like I was part of something. I mean, I know I'm part of something, but I wanted to do it rather than just talk about it. You know, so I wanted to be about it. And so that's another factor why I started this podcast called Next Gen Podcast, because we are the next gen podcast, and we are the next gen, you know. And we have this amazing opportunity to not only get, we have currently, we're living in a world where we have the most opportunity to become successful, at the same time do certain things that our parents never really had the opportunity to. So you know, I think it would be very, very wasteful if I never took this opportunity to not only share my experiences, share my thoughts about a particular thing or a particular matter with y'all, and not share with other people as well, you know. Because you know, again, I made a promise to myself this is way back in like maybe 2018, 2019, where I stopped judging people based on their appearance. Rather, I'll stop judging them based on their appearance, you know what I'm saying, and keep an open mind. Because I remember going to the store and getting something from my mom's, and you know, I saw this guy, and he was this old black guy, and you know, he looked homeless, you know what I'm saying, because you know, he looked like he had anything. And you know, but some my reason, I decided to just talk to him. And you know, when I talked to him, my mind was blown away. I was like, whoa, what? And he was like, yeah, and he's you know, he was part of the military, the I think it was either the army or the navy. He has grandkids, he has properties, this and that. So I'm like, damn, for real? He's like, yeah, man, I got all this and that going on. And you know, ever since that day, man, I ain't go old. Ever since that day, I made that promise that I would never judge anybody just based on the appearance, you know. And you know, so that was something that was a life lesson that I've learned, and you know, I kept to my, I know, I still, and I still, you know, keep to myself, or not also keep to myself, but I still, it's still part of me to this day. You know what I'm saying? I don't judge just because you don't, just because you don't have a particular thing, you don't have, you know, certain clothes and all that, you know what I'm saying? And I also wanted this to be part of my legacy as well. You know, when it's all said and done, I wanted to look back on it and be like, hey, you know, I started this when I was in my early 20s, you know what I'm saying? And you know, I created this podcast called Next Gen Podcast with friends, and I met these amazing people. They talked about their faith in God. They talked about the brand that they have. They talked about how they overcame certain things. And you know, again, it was just part of a legacy that I wanted to do for myself and my kids. You know, so I want them, the dad, to know that I was part of something, or I was doing something impactful. You know, and the reason why I say impactful, because there may be a particular person, you know, like yourself, that's listened to this or listened to a different, you know, different episode of my podcast. That's like, oh wow, there's a girl that's, you know, that was in the PWI, and she faced the same thing I faced, but she overcame them. So she can overcome them. I know for sure I can do that. You know? And you know, cause again, we know we all think, I don't say we all, but majority of us feel like we're all alone, or we all have we all just we damn, how do I say this? We face different situations when we don't. And that's also another factor why I wanted to create this this platform, to give certain group of people a chance to tell their side of the story, to tell their experiences, to help not just themselves, but people who are listening to this platform, to this podcast, to give them their an open minded, and hopefully as well as bring that towards God and towards that self, to find yourself, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it took me a while to figure out myself, who I wanted to be, who I really was. Because at that time, you know, when I was in high school, I was trying to be the person to, I was trying to fit in with a group of people that, you know, to this day that I don't really remember or, you know, talk to like that. You know, I wanted to be popular, you know. Again, you know, you know what I'm saying? I know it sounds funny, but like, man, that's what I was, man. That back in high school, man, I was trying to fit in, because, you know, I didn't know what I was really doing. All I knew was I wanted to get good grades and graduate, but since I wanted to be popular, you know, I was like a little bit lost. It wasn't towards like after I graduated, I got the diploma, I went to community college, and you know, I started to figure out myself, started to realize, man, you know, I don't give a damn what people think about me, really, you know what I'm saying? no disrespect, but I'm just keeping it hung with you. I to this day, you know what I'm saying? I really don't, you know, it doesn't really matter what people think about me, because everybody has their own opinion about me, and that's cool. The people I really care, or the other people that I want to hear their opinion on is, you know, my circle, my friends, my family, my girlfriend. You know, people that I really marry in my life. That should apply to you as well, you know? But going back to what I was saying, so I graduated high school, went to community college, and met this professor of mine. You know, he decided to one day to give us a sheet of paper, and like there was a list of careers that that we would like we would want to do, or things that we would have interest in. And out of the whole list, social work stuck out to me. And you know, I ain't never heard of what social work before. I'm like, what is that? Is that a new word? Is that something that just been invented? So I did what anybody. I went to Google. I typed in social work, and you know, I was like, whoa, hey yo, let's go. It piqued my interest so much. When I'm sorry, I'm like, damn, this is me on paper. You know what I'm saying? And then I started to, once I realized there's different levels to this, like you have a social worker that works in the school, you have a social worker that works in private and public government institutions, and you have a social worker that works in the medical field, and we can make 6 figures from this. I'm like, 6 figures, hey, sign me up, man. And then, you know, so I'm like, okay, you know what, I know what I wanted to do. So then, now it's time for me to go to the school that I think that would be that would help me with that. So I prayed about it. No lie, I prayed. I asked God to put me in a school where it would help me grow maturely, to help me come out of my comfort zone, but at the same time would also help me with my faith and help me not just talk about it but be about it. And I did what everybody did, applied to some colleges here and there, and one day in the mail, I got a letter from PV saying, congratulations, we accepted you as a student at PVMU, you know, at Prairie University. And then, you know, I'm like, okay, that's what's up. I didn't really think much of it, really, you know, because I thought, you know, again, it was just like, you know, they accepted me, like, and whatnot. Because I did some little research. I'm like, okay, they accept people. That's cool. That's what's up. And then, you know, once I got into school, I was like, okay, you know, I was like the new kid in the block, you know. I didn't know what I was really doing. You know, I had to use Google. No lie, I had to use Google to get to my classes, man. And if you know, you know, bro. You know the struggle. And but over time, I got used to the environment, and I stopped using Google. And one day, I met this lady, Miss Miles, who works in the student education. And you know, I didn't think much of it, you know, because we see each other from time to time. We pass each other by, and it'd be so random. And you know, I'd be like, man, I'm always passing this lady every time, you know. And I decided to go to her office and, you know, just have a conversation with her. And you know, once I had the conversation with her, it was just like, wow, I can relate with her. I can understand her. And you know, this, and you know, while I was at PV, I kind of stepped away, or my faith in God was just in a different, was just, I just backed away. I pulled away. And you know, I knew I pulled away. Not saying because I wanted to, but just because I wanted to experience the lifestyle that PV had for me. But funny enough, like I said, I met this lady, Miss Miles, and she was a Christian. She's a Christian, and you know, she told me something that only God, only someone would tell me that God. That God would know. And when she told me that, I was like, damn, it touched me. And you know, I went back to God, and I was astonished and a little bit frightened too, because damn, it's funny, because like, even when I stepped away from God, God never stepped away from me to this day too. And you know, and then you know, I started to meet other people like Mr. Freeman, who works in the Student Conduct. You know what I'm saying? He's like a big brother of mine. You know what I'm saying? I look up to him. You know, whenever I have a particular question, or you know, I'm a little bit lost about certain things, I'll go to him and I'll ask him. And you know, he'll give me his opinion. He'll keep a hand with me. And that's how I realized, like, okay, I was here for a reason. Like, I was here for, it's not just a coincidence that, you know, the people around me are telling me certain things that only God would know. You know? And ever since then, I've just been going through the journey. I've just been like, whatever happens, Father, just I'll let you take control. I try not to worry about how my class is going, my grades are going to look. Or this gonna be, how am I gonna get a six figure income with my job, with my major and all that. I try to focus on the person I should focus on in the beginning, which is Jesus Christ, because when I focus on him, everything else has just, every problem has just faded away. And you know, to this day too, like, you know, now I worry, but I don't worry as much, you know, because again, I have no control over certain, I don't have control over certain things. Although that I really have control over is the decision that I make while I'm here on earth, you know. And you know, fast forward again, I started to meet amazing people, one of them being a T. And you know, like I said, I talked about how, you know, how we wanted to do a podcast and all that. Now fast forward to now, 2023, you know, I've been doing this for a cool minute now. And you know, it's been nothing but a blessing, and I'm thankful to God to giving me this opportunity to do this. You know, I don't ever want this to glorify me, because again, I am nothing but a humble servant. I want it to be glorified God, and show his works, his wonder, show him that, hey, even if you stepped away from God, God has not stepped away from you. You know? Because he hasn't for me. And I'm always thankful for that, you know? And yeah, that's why I started. That's why I started this podcast. Hopefully y'all enjoyed this this discussion of mine, just my side of the story. And without further ado, man, I want to give it to a I want to close it out with a good song of mine. You know, shout out to my brother Zoo, man. That's Z-O-U, man. He's a Christian rapper, underrated as you know what, boy. You know what I'm saying? I've been telling him, man, drop an album, man. Zoo, drop an album. And he has a single called Slide, man. You know, it's a hot track, man. I ain't gonna hold you, man. It's a hot track, and it's one of my personal favorites. And without further ado, man, you know, Zoo, take it away.
In this well, I'ma ride. Devil tryna give me deals, he a lot. I don't trust the new age or the vibes. I'ma wait till my God come in, slide. Never die, ready, ride. You ready, then ride. Come in, slide. Never die, ready, ride. You ready, then ride. Slide it, yeah, ride it, yeah. Midas touch, exotic, yeah. Praise to the Christ, he's rising. Yeah, dead men of life, iconic, yeah. Acknowledging my ways, Christ the one who paid. And he got it, never doubt it. Ride the waves, I'm on boys who is gnarly. And I'm led by the spirit, no Bacardi. That's just how I move, going for the loot. Where do you accrue? Treasure, earth, or heaven? Your hearse is ready. Either die to yourself or you're dying really sweaty. Cause hell is real hot, can't go out at Ed and Eddie. When you spin like chasing coins, Satan's deli to the belly. Won't you come and tell me, hit me on my celly. I know the message heavy, but we ride into the heavens like, yeah. God put me in as well, I'ma ride. Devil tryna give me deals, he a lot.
And that, with that being said, man, it's a wrap for this episode of the GEN Podcast. I'ma see y'all soon on the next Zoo. Come in, slide, never die. Ready, ride, you're ready, then ride.